Hello, I'm Alex, and in this second part of this video series, I will be installing Bitcoin and Altcoin wallets on a fresh WordPress installation, and I will be connecting the plugin to the Bitcoin Core wallet. And then I will be defining a Bitcoin currency that will work with that wallet. So let's get started and do that. Now, as I said earlier, version 6 of the plugin is not yet on the WordPress.org repository, but it is available on the dashed-slug.net website as a release candidate, so we will be using that for the time being. Later on, you will be able to install the WordPress plugin from WordPress.org repository normally. So let's go to dashed-slug website, and then Wallets and Bitcoin and Altcoin Wallets WordPress plugin. Now, this is the homepage for the plugin, and here you will find detailed instructions. Basically, first of all, there's a complete feature list, and then complete installation instructions where you can follow step by step only the parts that you need, or all the parts if you want a complete installation. So let's scroll past that because there's a lot of information here. You can see here is the installation instructions. You can follow these, or you can follow this video if you want to install with Bitcoin Core. And then we can skip here to the download section and download release candidate 7, which is the current release candidate. Again, usually you would install the plugin from the WordPress.org repository. Let's skip to this fresh WordPress installation that I have here, and I will go to plugins and add new. I will be installing the plugin zip file, and this is actually what you would be doing if you would download any app extension or wallet adapter extension from the website. So click upload plugin, browse, and find the zip file that we just downloaded. Open, install now. This is a bit slow right now because I'm running it on a VM, which is slow, but if you do this on your web host, it would be much faster probably. Let's activate the plugin. And once the plugin is activated, we will see four new post types. These will be wallets, currencies, transactions, and addresses. These are the main things that the plugin works with. So we will be defining a new wallet, which will encapsulate all the connection settings to our actual Bitcoin Core wallet. The VM should be finishing by now, anytime now. Ah, here it is. Now, let's refresh the page once. And here we'll see at the menu, wallets. Let's create a new wallet. We don't have any wallets yet. Now here we can name the wallet. Let's name it Bitcoin Core. And I will have to say what type of wallet adapter I'm going to be using. Here I'm going to be using the Bitcoin Core-like wallet adapter. This works with Bitcoin Core or any wallet that has the same JSON RPC API. So for example, Litecoin, Dogecoin, Bitcoin Cash, these types of wallets. As you install more wallet adapters, you will have more options here. So if you would install the Monero wallet adapter, you have it as an option here. Let's publish this first, so that the plugin knows that this is a Bitcoin Core-like wallet, and then it will ask us the right questions to connect to the wallet. So when the page refreshes, we will see the settings that you need to enter to connect to the Bitcoin wallet. Now, of course, you need to set up the Bitcoin wallet on a server that is accessible from your WordPress host. So let's check our server. I will go into the console and SSH into the server where I have already installed a Bitcoin Core wallet. you like my message of the day, please give me a like button. Cut. Now I'm going to show you my Bitcoin conf file. And it's a simple Bitcoin configuration. I'm running testnet here, but the same procedure is for mainnet. I have set a username and password, and I'm allowing the IP of the WordPress host to connect to this server. And also I've set RPC bind, which is actually very important because otherwise it won't work. So you need to set here the IP address that you are binding to. This is the IP address of the wallet server. So let's start the Bitcoin daemon. And now it's starting. And now here I will be setting the IP address and port and all that. This is the IP address of the server that is running the wallet. And this is the TCP port. This is the username that I've selected. I'm going to enter my password, which was slug power in the previous screen. And here I'm going to be setting a passphrase, which will match the passphrase that you've used if you've encrypted your password file. Now, of course, it's a very good idea to encrypt your password file, because otherwise, if somebody steals your password file, then can get your private keys and steal all your funds. So we always want to encrypt our password file, and I will enter here the passphrase, which will be stored on the WordPress database so that the plugin can perform withdrawals. Now, if you're not interested in performing any withdrawals, then it's best to not enter the passphrase, and then you have more security. So let's save that. You don't need to change the remaining settings. And now we'll also enable the wallet, because otherwise it will be disabled. Now let's check if the wallet works. We can go to the listing of all wallets, and next to each wallet we can see the status of the wallet. If everything works, then we'll know. And here we know that it works because we see the version of the wallet and the block height, which means that we've connected successfully. Now, if there was a problem, then we would see it here. Instead of the version number, we would see the connection status, which would inform us as to what is going wrong. Now, we've defined a wallet. We also want to define a currency that will be connected to that wallet. Obviously, for Bitcoin wallet, it would be the Bitcoin currency. Now, we do this because in other situations, we can have wallets with multiple currencies, and then we can assign multiple currencies to one wallet. But right now, we need to create a currency. In this case, because the plugin sees that there were no currencies defined, it has already defined for us the Bitcoin currency. If we want to create a different currency, we can click on Add New. But right now, let's edit this Bitcoin currency. And here we will set the title to be Bitcoin. And let's make sure that the CoinGecko ID is correct. Now, you don't need to enter a CoinGecko ID necessarily for your currencies. But if you do, then the exchange rates will be loaded from CoinGecko. So we'll have Bitcoin here. And of course, the ticker symbol will be BTC. And this is the important part. We want to assign this currency to the wallet that we created earlier. So, Bitcoin Core. Decimal places, of course, is 8 for Bitcoin. And here we have a display pattern. You can check this. Actually, there's a lot of documentation here. We can set, for example, the withdrawal fee to be 10,000 satoshis, for example. And let's update this. The plugin has already loaded an image for our currency. If you want, you can change that. And now our currency is ready. Let's go to currencies and we'll see the balance for that currency. Now, you see that this is a hot wallet balance. There is a hot wallet balance on the wallet. So this is a 5.25 testnet bitcoins that I have here. And none of it is assigned to user balances. So this is an important distinction to understand, that there are user balances which are actually derived from the plugins ledger, and then there's the hot wallet balance which backs these balances. So a user or many users may hold balances on the plugin, but in order for them to be able to withdraw these balances, there needs to be hot wallet balance backing that. Of course, you can move some hot wallet balance to a cold storage for safety and all that, and we'll talk about that later. Now, for now, we have defined our wallet and currencies, and you can skip between the wallet and the currencies. Here, if I click, I will go to the wallet. Now that we've set up the wallet and currency, we can start using some of the plugin shortcodes. The plugin features a number of UIs that let users deposit, withdraw coins, and transfer them, and do other things like view their balances, exchange rates, etc. So I'll see you in the next video for that. Thank you and take care.